Everybody.
Go.
Welcome to the big game. I'm Josh Schumann.
And I'm Dane Massey.
And we are at the big game. The big game is currently going on. The Round Lake players are being introduced right now.
What an exciting event for both spring sports and the Special Olympics team for being recognized. They just went to state to qualify.
Yeah, they just qualified at state last month. And a few weeks ago, they won the NLCC Buddy Ballers tournament.
As they look to face the Round Lake Panthers as this exciting matchup, the atmosphere is huge as we get ready for the big game coming up in just a bit.
Oh. Honor is defended. I stand.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this special episode of GNHS TV. The big game is here. The time is now, and we recognize the spring sports and our Special Olympics athletes as the game is just about to get underway in just a few minutes. Also, if you're going to post anything, take a picture, do it with a hashtag, inclusion revolution.
I'm going to welcome Morgan Atwell, senior Morgan Atwell, to the floor.
The big game tip-off is coming up in just a bit.
All right, everyone. Before we get started with the big game, we wanted to run through a few cheers with you so the whole gym can get involved. Listen for us during the game so we are all ready to cheer on our athletes. The louder the better. Let's practice a few chants right now. Superfan leaders, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, everybody, sounds like we're getting ready to roll.
As we welcome you to the
big game.
We welcome you to the first quarter of the big game as we get set to host the big game. The starting five for the Knights are Sean Hogan, Joseph Sharkin, Kellen Bovo, Teresa Zapanta, Abby Christie, Andrew Perez, Jed Padernos, and Jacob Kolick. As we get set to start the big game, a nice tip-off there to start the game by Sharkin as we are off with the big game 2020 as Grays Lake North will start the ball. Here goes Sharkin. As Sharkin is a dab there as it will be stolen by Round Lake. And a nice fake out there by Sharkin as Round Lake will get the ball back. And the first measure will be made by Round Lake, by Edward Taylor, the first points of the game to start the quarter and the big game. As Grays Lake North, it was Sean Hogan to inbound. Going over to Joseph Sharkin. As Sharkin will take him down the other way, guarded by the Panthers. Great defense there by the Panthers. It will be stolen. It'll be taken the other way by Round Lake. Joseph Sharkin with some nice defense there. Be kicked outside. 3-point made, and that will go wide. It'll be Edward Taylor. As it'll be a nice steal by number 16, Alberto Perez, as his shot goes no good. Perez looking to try again. That shot will go no good. And it'll be rebounded by Sharkin as Joseph Sharkin comes back the other way. This shot will be off the rim and no good. Rebounded by the Knights, and that'll go off rim and rebounded by Edward Taylor. Here comes Taylor the other way. As Taylor will try for three, that'll go no good. Rebounded by Perez, as Alberto Perez will try one. That's no good. Rebounded by Donald Taylor, and the layup will be good by Edward Taylor. And the Knights will come back the other way with a 4-0 ball game. And it'll be Jason Sharkin. And Sharkin will try it too. That's no good. Rebounded by Hogan. As Hogan will try to go up for it. And that'll be no good. And it will remain the D127 ball. And it'll be a layup. And that'll go no good. Rebounded by Ryan Lake. Rebounded by Donald Taylor. And Taylor will pass over to Aguilar. Aguilar will try to shoot one. That'll go no good. Rebounded by Alberto Perez. That'll be no good. It'll be rebounded by Taylor. And Aguilar will get it done. He has scored all the points. Yeah. Okay. That's terrific. Zapata. And it'll be given a number 33. And it'll be thrown in, it'll be stolen by Diane Taylor. He'll pass in the Aguilar. And he'll pass over number 2, Miguel Garcia. And it'll be stolen. And it'll be taken away by Jed Padrona. Nice defense there by Padrona. And they'll be rebounded to Gazek. And they'll be rebounded to Gazek North. A nice shot there, and that'll be off the rim. Almost had a basket there. Rebounded by D127. He'll try one, and that'll go no good. Rebounded by Round Lake. And they'll be thrown all the way for Donald Taylor. A nice block there. A brilliant block there. Great defense there by Jacob Kolick. He'll be thrown in to Donald Taylor. A Taylor heading over to Aguilar. Guarded by Kolick. He'll be thrown up in the air for Miguel Garcia. It will be rebounded by Aguilar. As Aguilar, it'll be rebounded by North. It'll be thrown into David. It'll be thrown into Jacob Pollard. Pollard, they're trying from inside the arc. And it'll be rebounded. And that's going to roll over the rim. And no good, rebounded by Aguilar.
So close right there.
Aguilar is going to pass it inside to Donald. That'll be
intercepted by number 42, Andrew Perez. And it'll be passed in to Sean Hogan. As Hogan looks to get it back, and that'll be stolen, and it will remain Sean Hogan. And Sean Hogan will take it up, and that'll be no good. Rebounded by Garcia, and then it'll go no good. Rebounded by Aguilar. Aguilar looks to call something. We have number 9, Christian Rodriguez, and Christian Rodriguez will inbound for round 1. Almost into the third quarter. As we will now throw it over to Brian Donaire with a sideline.
Brian Donaire here at the big game with Mrs. DeFioris. Hi, Mrs. DeFioris.
Hi, how are you?
So tell us, why do you think it's important that the big game is going on at this time? Why do you believe that the big game is so important for Grays Lake North and just the whole squad, like team as a whole?
So for the school aspect, it allows everybody to cheer for everybody. So I love that. And I love the fact that we all get behind everybody on the teams, and it's an incredible experience.
What is one of your favorite things about the big game?
I can't hear you.
What is one of your favorite things about the big game?
So I love it. No matter who scores, we all cheer. It's the best.
And what is one of your favorite things leading up to the big game throughout this whole week? Because I've noticed that we've done a bunch of different things that we haven't done in previous years.
So we got to decorate our students' locker, and we had lunch with them, which was a lot of fun. We played Get to Know You Bingo.
Oh, thank you. A lot of hype at the big game. Yeah.
Thanks, Brian.
All right, I have to go.
Score right now is 8-2 in favor of Ryan Lake. North hit a shot with Pierce at the top and hit a spot. He has only 2 points from North. And so far, here Aguilar has all 8 for Ryan Lake.
done with their performance, I think we're going to be getting ready to introduce spring sports.
Let me recognize. We will be in San Francisco track, led by Coach Walter. The girls are coming off their best season in school history after winning the indoor conference last year, and they're picking up right where they left off. They've been off to a hot start by being crowned back-to-back champs at their first two invites, and are looking forward to turning some heads this season.
Next up, all levels of baseball. Stand up. The Knights are coached by Coach Bill. Varsity is excited for their spring break trip to Disney, and all levels are pumped for their home opener on March 28th next morning. Good luck to all levels of baseball.
Next up, put your hands together for our next spring sport. Boys, track and field. All levels of boys track will stand up. Boys track is coached by Coach DiStefano. There's a new base. The year's strong, including a new pole vault school record for freshman Peyton Smith. Their next meet is the NLCC Indoor Conference meet Thursday, March 12th at UW Parkside. Make sure to follow them on social media. Follow Director Armada on Twitter for boys track updates and results.
And tonight is the opening.
I'm here with the new head coach for the boys track team, Coach DiStefano. Hi, Coach DiStefano.
Hi, how you doing?
So tell me, what are you most excited about for this year's track team?
Well, I'm most excited about having these new athletes come out, some for the first time, even as juniors and seniors. It's great to see that, and you know, we've got some new coaches on the staff, so we're looking forward to see what we can do.
And what is the new mentality that you guys are going for now that you're the new head coach?
I think it's a little old school mentality. We're going to work hard and try to improve and see what we can do.
And what is one of your goals that you have for this year's track season?
Well, obviously we want to be competitive within the conference and place in the top half, but hopefully get some state qualifiers as well.
Thank you, Coach DiStefano.
Thank you.
Now back to you guys.
Lucas Ego, Sydney Rose, and Alex Victoria. There we go. The crowd is getting into a fun with the roller coaster. All right, here comes the inbound. Panthers taking it down the court. Number one, Mariana Garcia. This is Panthers' shot, and it is no good.
Why are we standing?
All right, here we go. Inbound. Number four, taking it down the court. Stolen by number five of Ryan Hayes on the fast break. He gets stopped. He puts it up and he stops. Barrel off. There goes Bradley. Bradley gets stolen by number five again. Number five is going down the loop. It's a second steal. Here comes number 25 with GM27. Takes it down the court with a layup. No good, but he gets the rebound. Puts it back up. The rebound. Takes it down the court. His own fast break. Uses his dribble. The 2500 pulls down the court. There's a three ball. And no good. Good play. Number 14, Angel Lopez with the ball coming down the court. There's that pistol there, but it's up. Number 5, the rebound, however. Let me pull the inbounds of it. Pass it over to number four, I believe. Pick it up, slightly off. Number 15, Zachary Jewett with the ball. Moving it down the court. Took a shot up, decided to go out of bounds. Let me pull with the inbound. Okay, passing Bradley Jenner with the inbound. Passing it over to Lucas Ego. Ego takes it down the court. Still dribbling down the court. He throws the ball. Still going. Fights for another steal. He's going around the court. Here he goes. Going up. And it's slightly off. Dominique with the rebound. Dominique takes it down the court. Takes down the court. He throws it down. Pass it off to number 15. Zachary Jewett. Zachary Jewett takes it down the court. Tony Poe with the shot. In and out. Dominique puts down the court on another fast break. These guys are dribbling down the court, avoiding a few GM27 players. He's still going around and takes the three. Slightly off. Henry Poe with another rebound. He's going on the court. Here he goes, up with the layup, and he's off.
All right, we have some substitutions.
There we go, substitutions are coming on the court. Very entertaining second quarter so far. It was 8-2 around Merck School. Sidney Walsh is going to inbound the ball. Passes it over to number 41, Armando. Dominique with another steal. Puts the shot up, and it's short. Five Dominique seems to be running the game right now, but number 4 has the ball, taking it down the court. The pass has pushed the ball up, but Dominique blocks it. Dominique is on a defensive carry right now. Taking it down the court again. He makes a nice pass inside the paint, and it gets stolen by Henry Pogue. Henry Pogue and Dominique are just battling it out right now on defense. Pogue loses his dribble. He maintains the ball, puts the shot up, and it's just good. Dominique slows it down. Passing to Jewett. Jewett is now taking it down the court. Jewett has an open lane. going to put the shot up, and it's just off the glass. Rebounded by number 41, Armando Paul. Armando's taking it down the court. Over to number 25, Henry Cole with the three. Slightly off the back of iron. However, number 4 with the rebound. Kellen Bolger. The ball goes out of bounds there. We go with the inbound, number 11, Edward Taylor. Teammates of Collins have ball, there we go. Over to number 14, Eric Garcia. Eric Garcia has the ball. Gives him a down the court, he's going to find the lane. Gonna put the shot up. It's him! 10-2 round make, 58 seconds left on the clock. And number 15, Sidney Walsh is taking down the court over to Henry Pogue, and he is slightly off. Dominique at the inbound. Dominique takes down the court. Henry Pogue drifts it, but he gets it back. There's a person open in the paint. Number 1 in the air, number 4. And it's him! As the crowd starts chanting Inclusion Revolution, stolen by number 14, Eric Garcia puts the shot up at the off. Henry Poe gets the ball. Going down the court. He's found the lane, he's found the lane. He's going up, right up. And it's slightly off. Number 4 does not get the ball. Dominique gets the ball. Once again, let's see if he can get this way up. It's up. He gets his own rebound, though. Henry Poe battling for the rebound. He puts it up again. Henry Poe gets the block. And that is the end of the quarter.
Let's give it up for our second quarter, Big Gamers.
One. Okay.
If you are a parent, family member, or loved one of any of our Big Game athletes, please stand up. We would like to thank you for giving the coaches and sponsors the honor of coaching these amazing athletes. And even more amazing, Big Games. A day like this is not possible without your support.
And now we're going to quick shout out to Winkler, who sponsored the Big Game Athletes this week.
And here with us, hi, I'm Dave Mass. This is Josh Schumann. Josh Schumann alongside me as the second first half. Oh no. We have an interview down on the court. Peggy and Moore.
Tight.
Brian Kennedy as Peggy and also Junior Stuff TV reporter, Terry A.
Thanks,
Dan. So we can see ourselves?
We're live.
All right. Thanks, Dan and Josh. I'm here at the amazing, energetic Big Game with one of the amazing Brian Kennebrew.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
All right. So, Brian, what's your favorite part about the Big Game week?
I just like how everybody comes out and supports everybody. We try to get everybody to come to everybody's game, so including this game, how everybody's rowdy. You got everybody out here dressed in the white. Just like the atmosphere is amazing.
I think it's a good time to show support to those who need support, and it's cool to see the whole school come together to support these guys.
I don't think Savion introduced him, but this is Alex Kagey, and I'm co-reporting with Savion. I'm Charlie Lay. Another question for you guys. What's your favorite part about the Big Game? With the athletes, like, do you think they show enough spirit? Do you think they show? Just tell us.
I think they have great spirit, and it's really fun to see them play the game.
See, I'm a basketball fan, so I love to see them go out there and get buckets. I love when people hit the itty bitty moves, and each team gets a bucket, I'm always cheering. I love basketball.
All right, so Brian and Katie, I know you guys are supposed to be in the teachers versus staff game. So, what is your opinion on that?
We got snubbed. there were some flaws in the refereeing and the rules of the game. But, you know, the real important thing is the big game and coming out to support our fellow teammates. So, you know, as long as I can do that, I'm happy.
I'm looking forward for Dimitri tackling some teachers, too. So.
Yes, sir.
All right. So, you know, teachers versus staff, who do you have?
You know, me and Kager are part of the group that created the game. So, you know, we put together a pretty lethal staff team. So, you know, I got my money on the staff.
Money on staff.
Have you guys heard the reports that staff are going to sub out for students?
No, I have not.
Never heard anything.
So, basically, we had a teacher's cheat. So, basically, they're going to get injured. They're going to fake like they're injured.
And let me say something. Let me grab the mic. The teachers won't need to do anything because the teachers got this one in the bag. They're going to take over. I got Miss D with the buckets. I got Alma Bree with the buckets. And I got a special weapon coming in. Y'all don't know him yet, but his name is Brent Jones, and he's finna give all these students buckets.
I will be a good game.
A lethal game. Yes, sir.
Thanks, Dan and Josh. Back to you.
We're back up in the booth after Brian Kennebrew and Alex Kennebrew showed their opinion with Savion and Charlie Rowe.
And currently, Color Guard is doing their halftime performance, and we will be getting on with the third quarter very soon.
A very, very, not the way the Knights want to go, but overall, nice defense by Round Lake and very well played by Gozer Mill. The score doesn't really show it, but it's really, really good effort by G127. I think they should be able to get back in this game. We'll show 12-2 in favor of Round Lake. Third quarter action coming up in just a bit.
Now we're going to introduce our senior big game athletes. Round Lake is going up first. Senior athletes, first with Monica Arroyo coming out of the tunnel. Next up, Michael Diamito, four-year veteran of the big game. Looks like he is with his mother. Bradley Drummer coming out of the tunnel. Excited as always.
Next up is number
Jacob Pollock next out of the tunnel with his father. Father.
Our next singer is number 34, Tim Rhino. And number 5, Joseph Sharkin.
Next up is Joseph Sharkin. One out for most big gamers is number 15, Sydney Welsh.
Seniors and parents, if we could get together, maybe even in a double row for our photographer to get a picture, please. We cannot miss this opportunity.
We're going to get a picture down on the court, and I'm sure we're going to get the third quarter started very soon. GoPro is back, ladies and gentlemen. The GoPro is back. Good to thank the parents of all sports. You know, parents do almost everything for you, and they support you and cherish you all the way there during your high school career. And especially our big game athlete parents taking a nice picture down on the court. And now it's time to start the second half of the big game. The second half will be started, and Dana takes the play by play. Thanks, Josh. We begin to start the third quarter for Round Lake 12. And there's our chance, too. And Brian Del Mayo down the court starts the roller coaster. And Brian Del Mayo on the court starts the roller coaster. He's set, set to begin the third quarter of the big game. As Michael Grimstead looks to take it in and inbound, 4-1 to 127. And we are underway in the second half of play. They're going over to Tim Rhino, as Rhino would try to drive the lane and throw it over to Grimstead. Grimstead, a nice drive through the hole, as Grimstead will go up with the shot. That'll be no good. Rebounded by Brown Lake. And that'll go out of bounds. And it will remain Brown Lake ball. Now that Brown Lake will try to shoot the three, number 18. And Rachel Perez tried that three. And now here comes Grays Lake North the other way. And it will be stolen by Alberto Perez. And Perez started by Tim Rhino. Perez goes up a two, and what a shot there!
A nice fadeaway.
Perez. A great fadeaway there by Perez. And it'll be thrown into Tim Rhino. He didn't stretch to keep it himself. Now he passed over to Tim Rhino. As Rhino will not come back the other way. As Perez now with a good guard. Good defense there by Ryan Lake. Here he's thrown in to number 44, Monica Arroyo. Arroyo gets that first shot. He'll be rebounded by Alberto Perez. Comes back the other way as Arroyo. And Perez will come back the other way. Arroyo will be in and out, and then good.
Perez came to play.
And then it'll be Tim Rhino now. He's take it back the other way. Tim Rhino will be guarded. And Rhino, this will shoot the three. Perez already there on defense by Ryan Lake.
Give it up for number 19, Leslie Davion. Oh.
got there by Deanna, and we're thrown over to number 10, Jose Ruiz, and we'll be thrown back over to Alberto Perez. And we're going to be intercepted by Tim Rhino. Here comes Rhino the other way. As Rhino will pass it inside, and that pass will be intercepted and thrown into number 10, Jose Ruiz. As that pass will be stolen by number 44 by Monica Arroyo, and it'll be stolen by Perez, as Alberto Perez comes back. Nice fadeaway shot. That shot will go in and out.
He missed the floater again.
And here comes Tim Rhino the other way. Rhino trying to try a three shot, and that shot's going to go off the back of the rim. Good rebound there by Ron Lake. And Jose Ruiz comes back the other way.
There'll
be a timeout call, the substitution will be made. A 16-2 ball game as Ron Lake leads. A 16-2 ball game as Ron Lake leads. And Tim Rhino will look to inbound.
Quick fact about Tim Rhino, also known as Timmy Buckets, is a Bulls fanatic, and he is a state qualifier for snowshoeing.
Shot now go off the backboard. Rebounded by Tim Rhino again. Tim Rhino with the layup, and that's good.
They don't call him Timmy Buckets for nothing.
A nice layup there by Tim Rhino. That shot would go just short, and it'll be rebounded by Rhino. Here comes Rhino the other way. And Rhino will try another 3-5, and that will go off the rim again.
Just off the back iron once again.
Rebounded. And that shot will go no good by Jenny Arrieta. Rebounded by Rhino again. And here's to try another 3. That shot blocked by Alberto Perez. Here they go yet again. That shot. Rebounded by Rhino, who don't fade away. I don't know no good. Rebounded by Alberto Perez. And that will be Jose Ruiz. He'll try his shot, and that shot will be short of the rim. It'll be rebounded. Rebounded by D127 as Tim Rhino is to take it the other way now. Tim Rhino gonna pass it inside, and that'll be a missed pass. That's coming to Jenny Arrieta. And Jenny Arrieta will get it back. That shot will go off the rim. That's gonna be a push there by Alberto Perez. Number 40, Lisa Hicks.
Fun fact about Lisa Hurt, she's a very big Lion King fan and a very big Lady Gaga fan.
And we're going down to the Tim Rhino. As Rhino will throw it inside. And that shot will go out of bounds. It'll be rebounded by Alberto Perez. As there'll be 30 seconds remaining in this third quarter. As Perez will inbound. Lopez. Lopez will try a three. That'll go no good. Rebounded by Lopez, and that'll be rebounded by Hurts. And here comes Hurts the other way. And
And Kurt gonna try to get a shot here. Nice take there by Hurt. 2 seconds
remaining. 1 second remaining. That shot went up there!
Finally goes up at the buzzer. Lisa Hurt with the buckets.
As Hurt gets it at the buzzer. And that'll be the end of the third quarter. As Ralph Lake goes down 10. And Ralph Lake up 10. As we go to the fourth quarter. At the end of the third quarter, it is 16-6 to Ralph Lake.
Hey guys, Charlie Lay here, live from the big game. We're going to be asking Dr. Roscoe a few questions. How are you?
Doing great.
How do you feel about the general atmosphere of the game right now?
This is absolutely amazing. All about the inclusion revolution.
And how do you think our players, all players on both sides, do you think they're giving it their hardest effort?
They're giving great effort, yeah. Both teams.
And the students, how do you think the students are just reacting to just everything?
Students are amazing. Just listen to the excitement.
Yep. Well, thank you for talking to us. Back to Dane.
Thank you, Troy and Principal Roscoe. Currently, more spring sports are being introduced and being cheered for as the upcoming fixtures are being introduced. And we're going to get the fourth quarter going very soon. Up next for the fourth quarter, we have River Avail, Libby Egbert, Alessandro Azamar, Michael Giannito, Finn Hopkins, and Eric Rivera going in for the D127 Big Gamers.
Put your hands together for the final spring sports to acknowledge boys tennis.
And the final spring sports to acknowledge is boys tennis, coached by Coach Kent. And they look to repeat as sectional champions. Star player Christian Aban will look to improve on his state finish of 7th place as a freshman, and he is going into his sophomore year getting ready to go into it. Apparently we're going to reflect on prior sports.
Football,
stand up. Football is being acknowledged. Breaking news as of today. The football team head coach, head coaching job is vacant as Coach Baker is looking to, he's going to take the head coaching job of Rolling Meadows football. So we'll see and give updates once the North football team has their new head coach. With some girls volleyball, I think they had a record-setting season this year in the fall, and I'm pretty sure they won the regional as well. They're putting a lot of hard work this fall, and they're still being recognized. Boys and girls cross country being recognized as our NHSC reported Charlie Ray. And now the marching knights are going to introduce.
These amazing musicians took first place, best color guard, best visual presentation, and grand champions at the Northern Illinois Rapid Morris University Marching Band Competition, and second place at the University of Illinois Marching Band Championships. Congratulations, Marching Band!
And now Juno Kiss's very own Kelly Patrick. She's being recognized for her endless feet. And also senior Sydney Swift qualifies for second as a bowling in the second year in a row. Senior Ben Ellington, All-State composer for marching band. And Turing also qualified for the IHSA State Tournament for the 14th year in a row, and he plays 6th overall in the division. Wrestling have 3 state qualifiers, Oscar Figueroa, Jake Dowsworth, and Mitchell Bezanecki. And Jake was our only medalist, he plays 5th. Fourth quarter. Michael Bonito, number 22, number 13, Yvonne Valero, and number 50, Eric Rivera on the court right now, along with number 21. And number 51, Finn Hopkins. Mistakes on the round neck roster. If there's any round neck rules, there's no rule. We're not meaning to mention the wrong names for sure. The rosters are wrong.
All
right,
next
man.
We're ready to start the fourth quarter, and it's Panthers ball.
There we go. And so it takes down the pole. Quick shot. Good shot. Michael Bonito lets it go out wrong. There we go, River with the inbound. Over to Michael Bonito. Michael Bonito takes it down the court.
We are reporting live from courtside, Sabian and I here. Let's watch. Phineas now has the ball. And Michael has the ball and he shoots! And he scores!
And he scores, let's go!
Now they're heading on down there.
We got Ron Mike taking it down the court. Goes up from mid range. Just short. Finn Hopkins with the rebound, but River gets it. And Michael's down the court. He has an open lane. He's going all the way.
And he scores!
That's 4 quick points. It's 16 to 10. Ron Mike. Number 3 with the shot, this shot, afterwards. There we go, stolen by number 3. And 2 shots for number 3, this shot. This is Michael Bonito again, taking down the court, looking to improve his game. He takes another shot. Oh, just off. Finn with the rebound, though.
Rebound. Finn has been fouled down low.
Finn gets the ball again. He's good. Hit it.
Finn. Oh,
Bonito.
Rebound. He misses. He's not.
Puts it up again.
Again. And he scores.
That's 6 points for Michael Bonito. He's bringing the D127 big ball is back. It's 16 to 12. There we go. Number 20 driving it down the court for Ron Lake. At the free throw line. Plays up from the free throw line. High arcing shot off the backboard. Michael Bonito coming down the lane.
Who's scoring? He got fouled right there. I don't think they call that.
Foul going that way. It looks like they'll be going that way. So it looks like they're taking the ball down. It's Ron Lake's ball. And the point guard's taking it down the court.
And we're back up in the booth. Here we go. He's going to kick the air for a verse to get the score. Number three, puts the shot up. Number three, oh, just off the back iron. Just his own rebound, and he's just hurt. He gets his own rebound again. Puts it up from the corner, just off the rim. Michael Bonino with the board again. We have 2 minutes and 44 seconds.
We're reporting live from the courtside, and Michael shoots, and he misses, and it's a rebound from Round Lake, and it looks like they'll be taking it down back to court.
Rebound snatch from the girls.
Back on us. Number three, again with the ball. She pulls up from three. Just off. And we're going to make six substitutions. Great. That's working a sportsmanship down there by Gio Perez. Just held Flynn Kyrie's shoes. Very good act of sportsmanship. As River comes in with the inbound. 2:29 left. It is 16-12. Round Mike. Here's Michael Giannino. Pushes up from the free throw line. And he's just off the backboard. Flynn gets the rebound though. Stripped by number three. River gets the ball. Just before it goes out of bounds. He's driving in the paint. Kicks off to Michael Giannino. He releases the dribble. Number three, Gio Perez, back down the court. He's stopping up the free throw line. He wants it all. Just out. Sends Michael Giannino back down the court. 2 minutes, 2 minutes. From the free throw line. Another big shot from Michael Giannino. He is on fire. It is 16-14, minute 47 left in the game. Number 7 of Ramay kicks down the court. Minute 30 left in the game. Michael Giannino playing defense now. And number 7, he slightly gets a tip on that, but he gets the rebound. Wilmer gets the rebound. Wilmer takes it down the court. He has an open lane. Here he goes. He takes it. He stops. Pass it over to Michael. Michael for 8. Oh, just off the rim. A minute 15 left. Michael gets the ball again. Puts it back up. Just short. Teams go for the rebound. But it goes out of bounds after Finn gets it again. Coach Wood saves the ball there. Finn getting hounded by Gio Perez. Over the river, over with the shot. John McLean needs a bucket here, but it's just short. Ball is out of bounds, 40 seconds and the clock is running. Number 8 is on, they kick the shot though, she's just off. Wilmer gets the ball, 36 seconds, here we go. Still up for the win.
Oh! Yes! Yeah! Let's go! Let's go!
Here we go. Wilmer takes down the court, 20 seconds left. We might get a buzzer beater here, folks, the crowd is into it, here we go. 14 seconds remaining. Gio Perez, give it to the left. Going baseline, he's going baseline. River with the defense. Gio still has power, puts the shot up. Just off. Here we go, number 21. As the boss is going down the court, 11 seconds left. Clock is stopping and going in and out.
They win it all.
Michael, rebound.
Let him not make it.
Right.
He gets rebound 30 seconds again. Best game!
Let's go! Final buzzer beater!
He gets the winner and the crowd!
That's how we
win! 10 points! Wow! That was great!
What a comeback!
Craziest game ever! Absolutely crazy! That is going down in GNHS big game history! Flip to the mid game, guys! We are looking at a live coverage.
Wow. Rebound at the end there.
I saw one overtime there for a second.
That was late.
Wait, what's that?
and the team's line up to the handshake line. What a finish to the fourth annual.
Hello guys, Brian Donaire here with three students from the integrated PE class. Seeing that you guys work with these really good ballers right here, how does it make you guys feel to see them in action, scoring buckets and, you know, making the most out of the big game?
It's the most incredible feeling, you know, like, you see these kids work so hard in gym class every single day, and, like, the past couple weeks they've been so excited for this, and, like, just to see the excitement that everyone else in gym is, like, showing, it's just the best feeling, so, yeah.
It's so great. We've been waiting this forever, and now seeing everyone, the whole community, come out and support them, I couldn't be more happier and just ecstatic to see this go so well.
I just love seeing their excitement and how they work as a team together, and they've been looking forward to.
All right, guys. Now back to you, Josh and Dan.
And we are getting ready for the student versus staff game. As Mrs. DeRozio and Hubert are down on the court.
Everyone in this building knows and loves you, Miss
commemoration for Mrs. DeRozzi. Oh, how do you think it is right here at night? That's my last student. And she gets a big cheer going off the court from the student section. As we are about to kick off the student versus staff game, this is going to be exciting, Zach.
This is going to be very exciting. So the students were selected from a KPP basketball tournament that was held last Thursday, and the winning team got to go compete in the student game we're about to see versus the staff.
I saw Mr. King taking a couple of shots earlier during gym class, so it should be interesting.
And here we are, the Oreo McFlurry is on the court.
As the McFlurries, the Luke Wilson, Thomas Ford, Jackson Von Allman, Bruce Cannon, and Danny Gold.
Hey Michael, we're coming off a great win. You had over 10 plus points. Tell me what you were feeling when you made that final shot.
Oh, so happy.
Yeah. You brought this team to another level. How are you feeling right now?
So excited. Go ahead, my team.
How do you feel about all the people out here cheering for you?
Yeah, that was awesome. I like it.
Congratulations on an amazing game.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Thank you. Now back to Dane.
Here we go. This is going to be interesting. We have 5 people on the court. And
it's going to get interesting. McKillop, we got D-Staff on the court, a few of our security guards, LeBrew, and it looks like we're going to get into a warm-up.
As Malik Wilson seems a little bit stunned that they were this many guys compared to the Kofi.
Now, the Kofi tournament last Thursday, the championship game, which featured the Oreo McFlurries also, was very controversial to say the least. two technical fouls in the final 20 seconds, so the opposing team did not get a foul at all. Very controversial, but here they are today, getting ready to face off against the staff. But as the cheerleaders are throwing, teachers hyping the crowd up, getting us ready to go. As this is going to get interesting, as there's only 10 minute quarters. There's only one 10-minute game.
I think uniforms are sitting.
All right. I'm here with varsity basketball and teacher, coach Todd Grunlow. How are you, Mr. Grunlow?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
What do you expect from your staff here? What do you expect them to be doing?
We're going
to
shoot and make a lot of three-pointers, as we just demonstrated in the first possession of the game.
And what do you believe the score is going to be at the end?
32 to nothing.
All right, that's a great attitude, Mr. Grunlow. Now back to you, Dane and Josh.
Looking to make a move.
Oh my god!
Almost broke it. And he's passing down the goalies. His goalies will take a three. That'll be no good. As the staff will go the other way.
That's on TV.
As it's after we're back to the Nicky Cannon. And he'll do a nice move there by Kilowitz. He can't get it to go. The layup goes no good. As that shot will go no good, rebounded by Kulowitz, going over to Wilson. Wilson, nice crossover to start this game, as Wilson will take a deep three, and that shot will go off the rim. And that will be staff goal coming back the other way. It will be staff ball coming back the other way, as it will be thrown in a mistake there by the staff, as a substitution will be made with Grunlow, the three, and most of the athletic coaches here on this lineup. Now we're going over to Kilowitz, as guarded by Grunlow, be going back to Grunlow. Grunlow will try a three, that'll be airballed.
Air ball from Dorn.
Nice steal by Wilson. Wilson goes to the layup, and that's good. As the McFarlanes have their first lead. Good break here. If that'll go top for two, that'll go off the rim. And it will be rebounded by Kilowitz as Thomas Kilowitz comes back to the way. As Kilowitz tried to pass it there to Von Allman. And they'll be thrown ahead. It'll be stolen by Dimitri Cannon. Pass it over to Dorn. As Wilson looks to make a move on Grunlow. As Wilson will pass it over to Von Ullman. Von Ullman looks to make a move on Debris, and then it'll be passed over to Kulowitz. And that'll be passed up top to Goers, who fires a three, and that'll be off the rim. And almost stolen there by Wilson. As we're approaching the 6:30 mark on this game, as it'll be thrown over to Labrie, as Labrie will try for three, and that'll be airballed, and it will go out of bounds, and it will go McClure's ball the other way. As Von Ullman inbound will pass it into Malik Wilson. It's a nice move here by Malik Wilson, as it'll be stolen by Grumlow. As a 4-3 ball game still, the McClure's have the lead. A nice three there, and that'll be off the mark. Rebounded by Goers. Now throw it over to Wilson down the court.
Such a smooth
nice
jump
move there by Malik Wilson. As Wilson will throw it over to Kulowitz, who fires a three in the corner. And that'll be off the mark. Rebounded by Von Ullman. And they'll give it back to Kulowitz again. Then we throw it over to Goers. And Goers back up top. That'll fire a three. That'll be off the mark. Rebounded. Tipped up there by Von Ullman, and it'll go out of bounds as Kulowitz tries to save it. And it will be Kent coming in, and Ball, Mr. Kent and Mr. Ball coming in, checking in for the night. And it looks like the Kulowitz will also check in. And he looks to throw it over to Josh for the next commentary.
And here we go. 5 minutes left to go in the game. It's
a miss, DiFiore.
DiFiore is taking it down the court. Taking it down. He got caught with the ball. Got it by Dmitry Cannon. Jack Coach favors with the ball. Oh, flip by Jackson Von Ullman. Super nice flip. Here goes the layup. Up and in. 6-3. Oriya McClure. Just off the hand of Tim LeBlue. Coach Kent jumps into the stand trying to save the ball. Coach Kent is going. He's trying to call a grab on Malik Wilson. And Malik's throwing it down. Possibly it's Miss D in the paint. Interesting move there. And Miss D's asking for the ball again, but Malik said no. And Malik took three, and it's just in and out. So LeBlue with the rebound. Skipped by Justin Von Ullman again. Using a shoot against the staff. Goes up for the layup, and he misses. Just a ball playing a good defense there. McClure up over to Favors. There he goes. Oh, tie game. 2 points left. This is a true option right here. A nice good move there behind the back. Leaves Malik Wilson in the dust. Shot from the corner. Just off. Mr. Cannon just loving Malik Wilson for a rebound.
Over to Thomas Kulowitz in the corner. Puts the shot up, and he's just off once again. Still off, still taking down the court. Got a lane. Posting up, nice move. Almost gets his own rebound. Sessions on Almond. Gets the ball passed over to Dimitri Cannon. Dimitri Cannon with a nice little crossover, surprising considering he's more of a football player. He showed that in the turn of the ball for this game. Tackle for loss. 0 points. Jenna Bowers with another shot that's off. Thomas Harris with the rebound. He loses his handle. Mr. Cannon passes over to Luke Wilson for three. And it sinks it. Minute 16 on the clock. As the Sixers are making another substitution, they better hurry it up. As we were ticking down to 1 minute, 11 to 8. They're down by three. There you go. Looks like Miss Buster with the ball. Out of Mesquite in the corner for three. And she hits it. We have a tie game. 55 seconds to go. Smith Wilson takes it. He's on first favors. New track up at this score. Jackson Van Allman for three. Looks good. Oh, just in and out. Skitty guy with the rebound. Over to Mr. Kent. Kent. Up on Dimitri Cannon. Ooh, nice move. Gets stuck in the corner over the skinny guy, goes up! He misses it on Jackson Van Allman! Jackson takes it down the court now, over to Mark Wilson, where he drops him deep, yes he does! And he's off! There you go, 20 seconds left! Over to Miss Buffy, 15 seconds to go! Takes down the court, Miss T in the corner again, to get another three, over to the security guard, he hits it! 13 to 11, 5 seconds left. Nate Wilson takes down the court. 3, 2, 1, Tommy for the win. Oh! That's game. Tommy Kulowitz for game from 3. Beats the staff. Dagger in the corner. This is Blue Dural down. And that will conclude the festivities to today's big game. We'd like to thank everybody for coming out tonight, coming out to the big game and supporting our athletes and just having a lot of fun overall.
As I am Dave Mass, this is Josh Schumann, signing off for James Justice TV. Good night, everybody.
Thank you.